subscribe now.
Today we are going to retopologize a model with Blender to reduce the amount of geometry, creating a new 3D object that takes the shape of the high polygon model. It's useful for to optimize the poly count, so it's ready to animate or bake in Substance Painter or Marmoset and use it in a game engine like Unity or Unreal.
So I will activate the overlays, I will set the viewport shading to solid, and I will turn off these lights I got here. The first thing what we need to do is to add another object. I will add a plane, Shift A, Mesh, Plane, and I will place it in front of the head. RX 90, G, Y, and I will put the what will be our low poly head in front of the high poly head. So I will go to edit mode. You can press this button, edit mode, or you can press tab, and it's the same. S for scale, and I will set the size of this plane something like this. This will be our first polygon of the low poly mesh. And now I'm going to activate the snapping tool. This tool will project our low poly mesh over the high poly mesh. So what we have to do is to turn on the snapping tool, this magnet icon, and by default it will be set with this option, increment. This is what you will see by default. You have to click here and press face. This option will project our low poly mesh onto the high poly mesh. So you need this button turned on and this option set in face. So now if I grab one of these vertices, when I move it with G, I press G, and the vertex is projected into the high poly mesh automatically. So if I do the same with the others, now I have my low poly mesh projected into the high poly. So now if I select one of the edges and press E, so I can extrude, I will be able to trace my low poly mesh into the high poly mesh. But as you can see, by default, I'm not able to see the low poly mesh because it's intersecting with the high poly mesh. It's very difficult to work this way. So what you will need to do is go to the object properties, the orange box right here, and select this option in front. This option will show this object in front of the other, and you will be able to see it much more easier. The color of the low poly is the same as the high poly, so also what you can do is go to the color properties and change the color to another color like blue or whatever. Okay. If you change the color and you are not able to see it in the viewport, it's because you need to go to the object option. If your setup is in material, single, random, or texture, you won't be able to see the object color. So you have to be here. offset color, and you will be able to see the color that you see here in the viewport, in the 3D viewport. And now we can continue making the low poly model. So you can press again E for extrude, go to the vertex selection mode, and you can move the vertices, and the vertices will snap to the high poly model. Another way to make this faster is pressing Ctrl and right click, and that will make an extrude and will rotate the edges automatically, so it's much more faster. And here at the end, if you want to make it like a bridge, select Shift and the two edges will be selected, and press F, make faces or edges. And here we have our first loop of faces. So now we can select the inner edge loop, and again, press E for extrude, press S for scale, and now we can select each one of the vertices and move it exactly where we want. There you go. Okay, so this is the basic methodology to retopo something. Next, what I would like to show you is some considerations to retopo ahead. The idea is to I want to make a polygon here like this, something more or less in the middle like this, like so. To retopo this surface, this head, it's a complex geometry. The idea is to make edge loops that follows the shape of the surface. So one way to do this is to make edge loops like this. We are going to make edge loops that follows the eye, one edge loop that follows the mouth or the lips, another edge loops like so, another edge loops that goes from the nose and to the chin, and another edge loop that goes from the forehead to the end of the jaw, something like that. Something like this. With the polygons, it will be something like this. So I'm going to extrude these polygons. And then we can fix the details. something like that. If you press the number 2, will change automatically to the edge selection mode. From here onwards, it's just to keep working on the model, so I will not speak anymore. But I leave you with the rest of the video for those who want to see more step by step on how to show the different parts of the face. Retopology itself is what we saw. It's something simple, but it's very important to take into account what I was telling you about the orientation of the polygons. They must follow the shape of the model, generally use four-sided polygons to avoid shading problems, avoid triangles and n-gons. N-gons are polygons of more than four sides, and try to rescue as much detail as possible with the polygon budget, so when the object receives light, you can appreciate the medium-sized details. I hope this could be useful for you, and see you on next video. It's important to have more or less the same proportions in all the polygons.